do 8K raw, C-log with autofocus, 4K, 120, yup. Mammographers, 45 megapixel. Frames per second wise, this thing is fast. You're gonna get 12 frames per second mechanical, you're gonna get 20 frames per second when you're in live view. So it.
Okay, I need these. Hey babe.
What?
Can I buy the Canon R5?
No, you have enough gear.
Hey, what's up fellow creatives? Khan here with a new video, and I have bad news. I'm diagnosed with GAS, or gear acquisition syndrome. Every few months, manufacturers come up with new stuff. New stuff that promises to improve the quality of our work. New cameras with higher megapixel sensors, better IBIS, better low light performance, and better autofocus. New lenses that go all the way to f1.2 to get that creamy bokeh in your work and to shoot better at low light. And then there are obviously the YouTubers who hype us up and review all the newest gear. And this drives us to make a decision towards a certain camera brand. You get the point. New camera gear is so exciting. I can't stop watching at reviews myself all the time. So I really get it. And after all, we all want the best gear to make the best possible videos and photos we can possibly make. And to be honest with you, I'm quite the same. I've been into photography a little over a year, and I've quite quickly upgraded my gear worth of 800 euros to gear worth over 8,000 euros. Would I advise you to do the same? No, not really. But I can tell you that every spare minute that I have in my life, I spend on improving my photography and improving my videography, because this is something I really want to do. But as I've said before, I really don't want you to do the same, because having the best gear possible won't make you a better photo or videographer. And before you even think about buying the newest gear, I think there are three different things you should keep in mind before you even think about going to the store and buying the new Canon R5 or the Sony a7S III. So the three different questions I want you to ask yourself are the following. Can you justify upgrading your gear? For example, if you're a well-established photographer again, or like a beginner, it doesn't even matter, but you're already making some money with gear and you can justify buying new gear because you can already pay your bills off, your rent, and so on, then of course, why not? Why shouldn't you buy new gear? But then there's another thing I would like to ask yourself. Are your skills actually good enough? Because let's be honest, if you get a red in your hands, but you don't know how to work with it and how to get those real cinematic shots, then it doesn't matter if you get the new Sony a7S III, the Canon R5, or a RED. If you don't know how to use the camera, then there's no use in buying a new one. So if you feel like you've mastered your camera already, then there's one more question you should ask yourself. Does the camera you have at this moment limit you? Because let's be honest, the new Canon R5 or the new a7S III or whatever other camera that has better specs than yours is quite appealing, because I'm filming on a Canon EOS R, and the thing that bothers me, to be honest, is that I can film in 4K, but that comes with a 1.6 crop factor. And of course I would like to have full 4K, but right now I have to film a full HD. Is that bad? No, not really, because the HD, the 1080p on this camera is really good, but you get the point. And of course, filming at 4K at 120 frames per second to slow it down really, really hard would be so cool. But do I really need it? Nah, not really. I can perfectly work right now with the 1080p I have in 60 frames per second to slow it down. Will I get that extreme slowdown? No, not really, but it doesn't even really matter. I think the only one who is going to bother that it's not that much slowdown is going to be you, yourself. And no one else is going to notice it, to be honest. So if you feel like you can justify buying a new camera budget-wise, and you feel like you have a certain skills to work with the new camera, and the camera you have right now is limiting you, then yeah, why not buy a new camera? By now you've probably seen a lot of videos already, which say that you don't really need the newest gear to make the best quality videos or photos. I recently saw a video of Peter Walbeck from Full-Time Filmmaker, which gave a beginner who is 5 weeks into videography a RED compared to one of his own employees who has over 5 years of experience. and they do a little bell. I'll link it right here so you can see that you can really make some quality content with cheap gear if you just have the experience. So this really shows that you don't need a news gear, so you have to need to sell your kidney or your liver or whatever to be able to buy it. This just shows us that skill is way more important than buying a news gear. And remember, you guys, the gear isn't the thing that's limiting you. It's probably you, yourself, that's thinking that you can't do certain things because your gear is holding you back. No, it's just you. Your gear can, to be honest, do way more than you think. So please, don't become too obsessed by looking at the big YouTubers and seeing them review all the newest gear and hyping it up. And what I've recently seen in some of the videos is that some of the big YouTubers also mentioned this, that if your gear is just working fine, you probably don't need to buy new gear. All right, that's it for me today, you guys. I wanted to make this video because I feel like a lot of creators are struggling with this. And watching all the biggest YouTubers have the newest gear is really tempting to think that you also need the newest gear. All right, that's it for me today, you guys. I wanted to make this video because I feel like us creators, we always look for ways on how we can improve our photos and how we can improve our videos. And one of the first things we usually look at is buying new gear, because all the YouTubers, they review the newest gear and we think that we need them too. But I swear, this could be further from the truth. So please improve your skill first before buying new gear. So I was wondering, are you struggling with wanting to buy the newest gear too? Comment down below. And if so, what would you really, really like to buy? If you think this video was valuable, please like and subscribe to this YouTube channel. This would really mean a lot to me. Creators, see you in the next one. Peace out.